And when you're going back, you will not go back walking. We are giving you $1,000 to board a bus back.
Twesige Brian, a pupil at St. Peter and Paul Primary School in Fort Portal, has today resumed classes since the reopening of schools after the COVID-19 lockdown. After the lockdown, Twesige never returned to class due to lack of school fees and other scholastic materials. Brian, who couldn't express himself freely in English, decided to speak in Rutoro. When the schools reopened after COVID-19, I did not start because my mother did not have enough fees to cater for us all. My mother asked me to be engaged in business, so I started vending salt. Although he was not in school uniform, Mwesije expressed happiness and gratitude to God for having answered his prayers and that he had returned to class. Now that I have been offered a scholarship, I want to study hard and become a lawyer. Twesige narrates that he made a decision to join the Walking Pilgrims while he was in town vending, hoping to get buyers. When I saw the pilgrims walking, I still had a stock of 4 packets of salt. I decided to walk along with them with the hope that I may get some people to buy them along the way. But midway during the night, the 4 packets of salt became so heavy, I decided to abandon them at Ruibale, where we spent a night. When we reached Namugongo, I went to every matter and said my prayers to him for intercession. Mwesije disclosed that he had not informed his mother about the pilgrimage and that after spending 2 nights on the road, his mother, Komuhendo Yosinta, joined the walking pilgrims to look for him. I walked because I wanted to pray to God to give my mother enough money for my school fees, but also money to buy us land and build a house because we live in a rental. As I walked, I never got tired because I had hope that my prayers would be answered. I always walked in front of the pilgrims though. They always cautioned me against getting lost. According to Twesige, his mother asked him to return home, but he refused because he was determined to reach his destination and pray for the intercession of the Uganda martyrs. When I reached Namugongo, I started praying so hard and interceding through the martyrs. I am so grateful to God that he answered my prayers. Now I am back in school. Komhendo says she's glad that her son's faith has paid off. Twesige went without telling me and I looked for him for 2 days. And when I got information that he had walked to the pilgrims, I transported myself up to Ribale where the pilgrims had reached so far. I asked him to come back home, but he refused. He insisted that he wants to walk up to Namugongo and pray. She explains why her son had to drop out of school. I have been struggling because I am a single mother and I do casual work to earn a living. That is why I had asked Brian to stop going to school so that his siblings can proceed. I had planned that he resumes education next year, but I'm glad that through his faith and belief in God, his prayers have been answered. Komuhendo thanked the Speaker of Parliament for standing in to support her son's education journey. Now that he is back to class, I don't want him to go back to the market. Let him concentrate on education. I am grateful to the speaker because it has been hurting me that those other students are in class while my son is venting salt in town. Immaculate Kobugabe, the deputy head teacher at St. Peter and Paul Primary School, confirmed that Twesige had never returned to school ever since the lifting of the lockdown. He describes him as a very bright and humble student who is determined to achieve his goals. Report by Roger Sunday for the news.